Hello people and welcome back to Peppy Art. Here's Will again. Today I wanted to try something new. Instead of just playing music to the video of the painting process, I want to tell you which thoughts crossed my mind while I painted the image, how I do interpret the image, and what I want to express with the image. According to what I told you in the previous video, I want to share my abstract thinking and philosophize about different stuff that I learned, how I see the world, and about everything. Okay, let's start. Often ideas for my art pop up in my mind as images. Half asleep, in meditation, dreaming means when I'm completely sleeping, or when I'm spaced up in my mind, I get the most or best ideas. These ideas are linked to my subconscious mind and the collective mind. I already heard from many other artists that they had the same experience. The image and the ideas evolve while the process of painting. Most of the time, I don't know what I draw or paint or what I'm going to draw or paint. I just start with a rough idea. Afterwards, means when I'm finished with the painting or drawing, I'm staring, meditating and thinking over the image for hours. This means I look at it, are relaxing and spacing out in my mind. With passing time, I discover more and more things I expressed in the image. Sometimes, even years after I draw and painted the image, I still discover new things. The more I learn about psychology and spirituality, the subconscious mind and about myself, the more I learn about the images. I often got the feeling that the paintings and drawings I made are expressing things that are ahead of my own conscious mind for even years sometimes. Well, now how I got to the idea for this image. At first, I had just a rough idea, as I already mentioned. I most of the time start with that. I wanted a strong perspective in the sky and with the forest. I wasn't even sure about the background at that point. My next idea was to paint the big glade in the middle of the forest. And in the middle of this big glade, I wanted to paint a giant monument struck by a thunder. Since the monument should become the focus point, I needed something really important, something that had a message. I just started with sketching the background and a few lines and left it like that for some weeks. While I left it for that, I kept thinking and thinking over and over again what I should paint in the middle of this glade. Then, one night, I've got a dream. I was back to a little child, sitting at a table and drawing something. The pig was really just a childish scribble in my dream. And what I drew was a giant lake or sea in the middle of the picture, surrounded by grassland. And in the foreground of the picture, there was a big crystal gate, which looked kind of similar to the Stone Age and surrounded by a fence. When I finished the drawing in my dream, there came an old man with a white beard and white hair and looked over my shoulder on the image. I curiously asked him, "What have I drawn here?" He smiled at me and answered calmly, "This, my son, is the gate of hope. It resides in your heart." At that point, I woke up and knew I found the monument for the picture I was looking for. Now I started the painting process. As you have seen already, I started the painting with the forest. The forest symbolizes the hindrances of life. Until you find your destiny and your right path in your life, you're just like a lost hiker in a forest, looking for a way out and cutting down the hindrances with the machete. The forest is dense, and while looking for a way out, you've got no orientation. But just as it is with life, as you pass more and more obstacles, you start getting a clue what your path will be. You start seeing a light in the forest and you follow the light, so to speak. Afterwards, I focused on the clouds. The clouds stand for the illusions and the thoughts dazing our minds. Together with the forest, they symbolize the society and our by society conditioned minds. They make the sky dark and let us lose track of our goal. They take our orientation and leave us wandering around in the dark. Just as the vaporized water of the forest creates these clouds, as the same as the obstacles in our life create all these thoughts, especially the negative ones, and we tend to get lost in them. Then I went on with the gate and the lightning. We all know this crystal clear moment, where we exactly know what we have to do and which path we will follow. In this moment, it strikes us like thunder. Suddenly, there comes this thought and hits us with all might. We don't know where it comes from, it just appears. It's so strong that it blows away all these thoughts and obstacles that danced our mind, similar to a shockwave. As a result, we get a clear mind without any doubt or fears, and then we decide without hesitating. In these moments, we realize this is how it was always supposed to be, that there never was another choice, and we start wondering why we even hesitated for so long, and what we have been afraid of for so long. In some cultures, they call it the divine who is leading us, God, Brahma, the universe, the collective mind, the one, and so on. But in the end, it's something that can't get grasped by words. This lightning opens a gate for us, a gate that's formed and fulfilled with love. This gate leads to happiness. It's a gate or a portal through our heart. The green crystals symbolize the green heart chakra, opened by white lightning from the crown chakra. While the thunder enters through the crown chakra, it passes and activates third eye or the Ajna chakra. This clears the mind and colors the lightning with a light pink or even a light purple. The lightning goes through our throat chakra, which is symbolized by the bluish peak of the gate, and then it passes all the way down to our heart chakra. In the end, I finished the picture by showing what awaits you if you pass through the gate. There's a sea for the peace in your heart. There are mountains which symbolize our goals that we know we are able to achieve. Above everything, there's an orange and a purple planet. Orange is the color of the sacral chakra. It's the symbol for passion, but also for the bond to every living creature. The purple color is the symbol for the third eye, or the Ajna chakra. The third eye stands for infinite intelligence and for infinite knowledge. It stands for seeing and seeking the truth. In conclusion, I want to tell you something about my dream. In my opinion, dreams represent a deeper level of consciousness and are linked to our subconscious mind. I think that the me as a child represented all my dreams and hopes that I evolved for life while growing up. The old man, on the other hand, represented the collective mind of the universe and the old and wise me, where we all are heading to in our lives. In the dream, I knew that my painting came from my subconscious mind. In that case, maybe even of the subconscious mind of my subconscious mind. And thus, I didn't know what I was painting or drawing in my dream. And then I asked the old man so that he could tell and explain me what I'm painting. Even while recording this audio, I realized more and more what I expressed in this image. And maybe I would even recap this in 1 or 2 years again. So I guess every one of us can see their own perspective in the image, in every image. And thus everybody of us see different things in the images and the art that they watch. So I don't want to dictate you what you have to think while looking my art or speed paint. I just wanted to share what I'm thinking and philosophizing about while I paint. Well, I tried to speak a bit calmer. I gave you a short overview about what I wanted to express in this image and hope you liked it. Please let me know if there's anything I can improve or do for you. I hope you liked the calm style of this video. And I wish you fun by continuing watching the speed paint. Bye, and see you next time.